Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, cherisher and sustainer of the universe, and may his choicest blessings be upon his final messenger, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family, his companions, radiallahu anhum, and all those who follow him. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban. Welcome to yet another quick and easy program, a joint production by ITV and Sayyid Global Productions. And welcome to a humble town out here in the Far East Randian Springs. Always a pleasure to have you in my home and heart, sharing some wonderful recipes with you. And yes, we've just seen the great day of Eid al-Adha Pasas, the greater Eid or the bigger Eid, in which we celebrate the ritual of Hazrat Hajra, one of the great women of Islam and one of the great women of Quran as well. And yes, we also, in the tradition of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, had to sacrifice an animal. And had it been our sons, Allah forbid, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most merciful. In his name we slaughter, for him do we worship. All worship is him, for him alone. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept you from us. And they say, you know, when you make a qurban, you're a sacrificial animal, not a single part of that animal should go to waste, whether it's the hooves or the head or the feet or the innards. And today we're going to be talking about innards, because the inside portions of it, actually it's been discovered. Well, it was a fact all the time, which is that we discovered it now in our modern times, how important it is to have the innards. In fact, there is an article that was taken out by Mullah Khalid Dorat, which reads, and I strongly suggest you read it. It's about the benefits of the liver of the qurbani animal. Remember, this is purely purified meat. Every aspect of it should be used or given or shared and eaten and enjoyed. Rasulullah ﷺ loves the shoulder. But we also need to eat the innards as well, because now doctors recommend you should be having at least once a week, you should be having innards. Today I'm going to show you something very special, which is how to cook the brain. Now, normally, it should soak a bit longer. My mom's idea is always to soak it in boiling water. But before we get there, let me speak about the ITV Quick and Easy recipe book. This is the book that you can find at... I think right now it's some copies at ITV offices. You can get a copy from there, as well as at the Ecclewires out in Dolly Retebe Road. So yes, you can obtain a copy there. It's all the tried and tested recipes in the past. And you can obtain one, inshallah, for your... So I think few left copies left, you can get it at Dolly Retebe on Dolly Retebe Road, Ecclewires and ITV offices. Having said that, let's now talk about the beja. Or it's in Urdu, it's called beja, but in English, obviously, the brain of the sheep. Now, how do you get this? You get this by actually having cutting the head out. There's a way in which you cut it, and actually, you're supposed to cut in smaller pieces, but I've just left some of it whole, so you can see it's actually the brain. It's not eggs. When it's done, you'll think it's eggs, but it isn't. Just to show you, this is the brain of the animal. And I'd like to also pay homage to all those wonderful people out there in Denhauser, all the entire Bomvan family. You know, you made it so special for us over the years, for our kids, and their fond memories of having spent it with you in Denhauser. And prior to that, all the Ilahi families out in 12th Street in the old Benoni, the original Actonville, which is in a location area. Wonderful memories. I'm talking about the early 60s and 70s. And then later on in the 80s, when my kids grew up in Denhauser and Newcastle, some fond memories of having made qurbani. And then their memories out here as well in Springs, at the Springs Muslim School, having done qurbani altogether. So we want to continue that tradition. We did that tradition as well this year out here in the farm down the road. Brother Aslam, fantastic provisions, facilities there as well. So time now to get on with the program. So this is the main ingredient for the first part of today's program is going to be the brain, how to cook that. The second part of the program will be the liver. Now, many of you are now cook this on Eid day, and I've saved some so I can share the recipe with you. The other ingredient, I'll do this in the second half. The other main ingredients that you'll have is obviously the ghee, and make it with butter or ghee. Very, very important, because it brings out the taste and adds on the taste of the innards as well. For the beja, I'm not going to use it for kaleja, but just for the beja, some very finely crushed onion. I know some people don't put the onion, but why I put the onion? Because at the time of the virus right now, it is a virus killer. in many ways. I'm not saying it is for COVID, but for normal winter flus, etc., it's extremely good. It's extremely good for the body. This is ginger and garlic paste. I'll be using about 2 teaspoons or 1.5 for the beja because it's a small amount. The dry ingredients, the cloves, the cardamom pods. I've got some green and white ones as well as some cinnamon sticks. Some fine red chilies as basic ingredients, actually. A dash of salt, a lemon, I'm going to be using not much. For some turmeric, just a dash of it. Some dana zira mix. I'm sure you know it's coriander in zero mix. Some lemon pepper, just a dash. Some salt, main ingredient as well. And I put some fine cinnamon. Some of you don't like to have so the big cinnamon in your mouth, so especially because beja is a small dish. And it's a delicacy. It's a rich dish. It's extremely good for those people who want to be strong. It enhances the immune system. It also is extremely good for strength and power, building up muscle, and also for your brain. Yes, it is. So all these benefits you can read up. You can research them yourselves, and I'm just sharing it with you. This is the garnishing. I'm going to use some of it as well. And I might just be using, I've just put in some olive oil. I've just put in some, so the garnishing is coriander and green chilies. This is some olive oil. I might just use it if I find that the moisture is getting lost. Some vinegar as well. And I might just be adding some salt and pepper. It just depends on the taste. So what I'm trying to say basically is a lot of it depends solely on the way you want to make it. Now, I know there is a tried and tested recipe that generations have been using, but you could do what works for your family. And for my family, they don't want it too spicy, but they do like a bit of gravy in it. And they want to eat it with roti, which I'm going to show you in a while when we do serve it. And they want to see a bit of gravy so they can dip the roti or the naan or whatever it is. Right now, for those of you who've never tasted this, I strongly suggest that you try eating the brain. Extremely healthy. In this time of scarcity, and it's getting scarcer and scarcer by the day, remember, use whatever you can to feed your family the healthy way. Let me put this book aside and start with the preparations. So what you're going to do is I'm going to first strain out the water so that I can get the full benefit of the taste of the part of it is sort of like parboiled. We didn't boil it, but we put it in boiling water so that it can cook. Put this aside. I'm going to add the ingredients in here, and at the same time, I'm going to put our ghee to get hot. A tablespoon of ghee will be fine, but if you want to use more, you'll get more gravy, which is fine. So I've got my plate on low. I'm just going to put it a bit higher. 2 cloves, 2 cinnamon sticks, 2 cardamom pods. Now, some of you might not even do this. You put it straight into the ghee. It's fine. So we have 2 cloves, 2 cardamom pods, 2 cinnamon sticks. In there, I'm just going to take a pinch of fine cinnamon. Let that simmer. And while that is simmering, back to me, I'm going to be adding the ingredients. All right. Again, if your family is suffering from high blood pressure, etc., go easy on the salt, right? So my husband just experienced 4 massive heart attacks. I'm a bit easy on the salt. I've just put in 3/4 teaspoon, 1 teaspoon of red fine chilies, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric. We don't want the color to go into yellow, just to give it some health benefit there. 1/4 dana jeera, right? A dash of pepper. Some of you might like more pepper, it's fine. I'm just going to use 1 teaspoon of lemon juice. Okay, a dash of vinegar, because you don't want the taste of the brain, so it takes away the smell and the aroma of the actual brain. So okay, this 2 level teaspoons, okay? Okay, this is ginger garlic paste. And give it a slight toss. This requires very gentle, slow cooking. So So while I'm going to add it onto that pot, I'm going to heat the other plate so that when we start in the second half of the kalaji, which is a very quick and easy dish to do, the beja will still, or the brain will still be cooking. Okay. So you won't believe what I do at this point. I just throw in a bit of fresh coriander, so to give it a lovely aroma. You'll see when I'm cooking, you'll get, I hope you can transport the smell, you know, the aroma when I'm cooking it. It should splatter a bit. So while this is simmering, I'm going to show you how to marinate the, it's already beginning to marinate the kalaji, which we are going to cook in the second half, which is the liver. Also innards, regarded as innards. This is from the stomach. Very simple ingredients in here. Teaspoon of salt or a quarter, because there's a lot more here. Teaspoon of fine chilies. And I'm not going to put anything, any other ingredients except some pepper and some ginger and garlic. A dash of vinegar. Very, very little. And just a teaspoon of lemon juice. Okay, let me marinate this because I'll be cooking this in the second half. This we'll put straight in. You'll see this gets done immediately, and the fresher to eat, the better. And this is especially good food to detoxify the body. Believe it or not, this is used to detoxify the body. It cleans the blood and gives you blood as well. So this has to get nice and pink. When this is nice and pink, I will add the beja or the brain. It has to cook on a low heat, so I'm going to bring that other plate to low, or bring this to low. This has to get nice and pink. So this is what it looks like, and this is what the liver looks like as well. You won't believe what I did on Eid Day. As soon as the sacrifice was done, Gurbani was done, I brought it home. My husband really helped me to get this together. He actually sliced it for me, so I just cut it. Now I'm marinating for you. And we had this fresh for Eid afternoon as well as Eid night. So, alhamdulillah. Extremely, extremely beneficial for you. Right. On that note, you're going to take a quick break. When you do come back, I'll show you when I'm adding the... I'll show you when I add the brain to it, and then let it cook, simmer, and put up the liver. Stay with us, we'll be back in a bit.